Hello and welcome back to the official Gather YouTube channel. In this video, we're going to be reviewing how to embed images within objects. I'm going to be using the poster object for the purpose of this video, just because I find that it is fairly common. We'll start here in Mapmaker by going over to the left-hand side and clicking Objects and then the plus sign to bring up the Object Picker. I'm in the See All category right now, but if you look down, you can see all of the other categories we offer, as well as St. Patrick's Day at the bottom. This is where we would list all of our celebrations or holiday objects. Below that, you'll see Insert Text and Upload New, but I'm just going to go to the top and search Poster in the search bar. You'll see the two options we have, which would be the Poster Set as well as the regular poster. The Poster Set is more freestanding, and then the Poster Object you would generally hang on a wall or something like that. From here, if you go to the right-hand side, you'll see the different color options we offer for this object as well. I'm just going to go with the blue today because it matches the image that I'm going to upload. And then we'll go down to Object Interactions and select Embedded Image. From here, you'll see the two required fields, which would be Image and Preview Image. I'm just going to upload the same file for both of those today, just because I don't really have a preview image that I'd like to upload, but I will show you where you can see the preview image and how it is displayed. And I am just uploading the graphic that I made super quickly just for demonstration purposes to image and preview image. And then next we'll go over the activation distance. The object is going to be the entire gray area in front of the poster as well. So I think that if I were to leave the activation distance as 1, that would give participants plenty of space to stand around the poster and view it. So I'm going to leave that as 1. Then we'll go down to advanced options. The prompt message is what participants are going to see as like an action to interact with the poster and view the image. I'm just going to leave it as press X to view the poster, but you can change that if you'd like to. I generally wouldn't recommend changing the object image or active image fields. If you upload something that has not been sized correctly, it is going to take up most of your screen because this is the field where you would be able to enter how the object does appear on the map. If you do want to do that, I would highly recommend watching our video that goes over creating your own custom objects. And next we will move on to the caption. This is where you can leave any notes or maybe if someone made this poster and you'd like to make sure that their name is attached to it, you can enter that in the caption here. And lastly, we will be going over the display start and end times. This would be if you wanted your content to be available to participants within your space between specific times, or maybe if your event starts at 6 o'clock, you can put the start time as 6 o'clock. So if someone does approach the object, it will not be interactive until 6 o'clock, and they will not be able to see that content ahead of time. I'm just going to leave those blank for the purpose of this video. So I'll go back up, make sure everything has been entered, and then I'm going to click Select. And then I will place that object where I want it. From here, you can also go in and place some tiles as well. So I'm just going to go ahead and place some impassable tiles over the actual poster so that people can't walk through it. And then I'll place some private space tiles as well. In the tile ID, I'm just going to put poster 1 just for demonstration purposes. I'm going to fill in that entire gray area here with that private space. That way someone walking by is not going to be able to interrupt the people that are viewing the poster. If you do plan on making multiple embedded objects, what you can do is place all of the objects just however you'd like them, wherever you want them to be, and then you can go in using the select mode tool and click it, and then enter the preview image and the regular image over to the right hand side. I wouldn't really recommend changing the appearance image, which is the top field, because that is where you would want to make sure that you resize it, much like the object image and the active image in the advanced settings when you're looking at that through the object picker. From here, I'm just going to go to the top and click Save, and then I'm going to go ahead and enter the space that I have open in another tab. You can see here I walk into the private space and it says you have entered a private area at the bottom, and then press X to view poster. The preview image is what you see just above that, where you can scroll, and then I'll press X to view it in the larger view. This is just the demo image I made. Over to the right hand side, you can see the eye where you can hover and see that caption that I mentioned previously. And then you can also zoom at the very bottom and then unzoom as well. In the middle, you'll have presenter mode, where if you click that, you'll be able to click around on the page, and everyone viewing that poster will be able to see those clicks, and participants can click that as well so that you can see where they are clicking if you're presenting. Now I'll walk over to the other images as well. You can see I didn't place any private tiles or any impassable tiles, so I can just walk through all of that. But this one here is the final completed one, how I would generally set up a poster or pretty much any kind of embedded image. It's the same process for pretty much all of our embedded images. I hope this helped, and for more tips and tricks, feel free to check out our other videos. If you did find this video helpful, don't forget to like and subscribe to help others find them as well. Thank you for watching, and happy gathering!